Hey, this is Matrix Prime with TFWarrior.com with my video review of Classics Megatron. Not since the original G1 line here in the United States have we actually seen a Megatron that transforms into a gun, unless you want to get technical and count the Megatron accessory that came with 20th anniversary Optimus Prime. So it was kind of a big surprise to me when I first saw prototype pictures of this online, and I couldn't wait to get my hands on it. Just for size comparison here, I have the original G1 Megatron here with me. And if I stand the Classics one up next to it, as you can see, the Classics figure is just slightly longer than the original G1 Megatron. And if I bring this out here to the side, as you can see, the Classics one is quite a bit wider. Okay, so we'll get the G1 Megatron out of the way here. Classics Megatron is actually not based on a real weapon, as you can plainly see. It's based on the Nerf Maverick gun, and it's actually a scaled-down version of that gun. The primary color in this mode is this whitish-grayish color here, which you can see makes up the majority of the gun. The next primary color is purple, which you can see here on the grip. There's some purple up here on the back underneath the scope. There's some purple here on the front of the gun. And then there's also some more purple here underneath the chamber. And there's some purple up here on the chamber itself. And of course, up here on the scope, we have the Decepticon symbol, which, as you can see, appears on both sides. And that is also painted purple. There's also some black, which you can see here on the back of the grip, as well as underneath the chamber here on the front portion of the gun. And then, of course, the scope itself is also black. Now, for a little bit of added detail, Hasbro threw in some gold paint applications. If we look here on the handle, we can see some gold here. If we look here underneath the scope on the back of the gun, there's also some more gold paint applications there. There's, looking up here just above the chamber, there's some more gold paint applications there. And looking underneath the chamber, we also have some more gold applications there, as well as on the front here, painted in these grooves. Now, as you can also see, there's orange here on the gun. The front of the barrel has this orange plug on it. The sight up here on top of the gun is also painted orange, as well as the front portion of the scope. Now, we also have some greenish-yellow translucent plastic, which you can see here on the chamber. And if I turn the gun around here so you can see, the scope also has the same greenish-yellow translucent plastic there on the back, and also here on the front. And if you actually look through the scope, you will see crosshairs, but because of the nature of this yellowish-green translucent plastic, when you do look through the scope, it's not really a clear picture. It's kind of light and dark. You can really only make out shadows and the outlines of objects. You can't really see them all that well. Okay, so holding the gun here, it doesn't really feel all that comfortable, at least not in my hands. If I bring back the G1 figure here, this Megatron is actually based on, well, it's actually a mold of the Walther P-38. So if you look at the grip, it's actually a ergonomically designed grip, so it is quite comfortable when you hold it. Going back to Classics Megatron here, it's not really all that comfortable. I mean, you can hold it, but as I said, it's not really made for my hands. Now, if you stick your finger in here, in the trigger, I guess this was made for people with really small hands, because if I stick my finger in there, I have to pull the trigger at least halfway back just to do so. However, once your finger is in there, you can pull back on the trigger and it does make a clicking sound. But of course, it doesn't fire anything. So I'm really happy that Hasbro was able to give us a Megatron that turns into a gun, despite the fact that it's not actually based on a real weapon. I'm pretty happy with the end result here. The only thing I would like to see have changed was a better designed grip. But other than that, I really don't have any complaints whatsoever. With that said, I'll show you the transformation to robot mode now. Start by separating the sides here. Rotating them down and out of the way. Next, we will rotate the scope down and out of the way. Rotate the body over. If I can lock this into place. Like so. Okay, pull the arm over. Lock that in position. Rotate this up. Open this panel to rotate the hand out. Lock it in like so. Rotate this up. Lock that into place. Once again, open a panel to reveal the hand. And shut the panel. Next, we take this section, this whole section here, and rotate this up into the back. Lock that into place like so. Take the legs, rotate them down and into place. Slide that up like so. And if we look at the bottom of the feet here, pull out the feet as well as the stands in the back to help hold the figure up. Like so. Pull open the front panel here. Flip up the head. Lock the panel back into place. Get the legs positioned right here so I can get the figure to stand up. Rotate the shoulder around so that it's correct. Get the arm into place. And what we have is Classics Megatron in robot mode. Now, what I have to say about this figure is it looks absolutely gorgeous in robot mode. The figure has lots of articulation. As you can see, the head rotates 360 degrees. The arms move in and out from the shoulders and the sides of the body. The shoulders can rotate. In theory, they can rotate 360 degrees, but not with the side panels the way they are. You can move them out of the way so that the arms can rotate, though. The arms, of course, can bend at the elbow. The legs can move in and out from the body. They can move forward and backward, and they can also bend at the knee. Over here on the right arm, of course, we've got the fusion cannon, which actually appears on the underside of the arm. However, you can rotate the arm around like so, and you can bring the fusion cannon up on top. Now, as I mentioned, I really love this figure, and the robot mode is absolutely gorgeous. The only downside is these huge wings on the back here. I wish there was a way that you could actually remove them and set them aside to display the figure in robot mode, but unfortunately, that's not possible. So with that said, I highly, highly recommend this figure. Especially just for the novelty of having a Megatron figure as a gun. But overall, it makes a really great display piece in robot mode, and I give this figure a solid 9 out of 10.